Hello. A few weeks ago, I got an email asking if it was possible to record or automate knob movements, specifically the filter cutoff on the Matriarch. If you look in the manual, you'll find a global setting to filter, or what we want, unfilter MIDI messages from the panel knobs. Unfortunately, this doesn't seem to work. There are no MIDI CC channels assigned to any of the Matriarch's panel knobs, at least not yet. But that doesn't mean we can't do it. So in this video, I'd like to show you a few ways to get a bit more out of the Matriarch using MIDI CC, and of course answer the question, is it possible to automate Matriarch's filter? I think most of us Matriarch and modular synth enthusiasts chose these instruments because we wanted a tactile musical experience and wanted to get away from screens and computers, and especially MIDI programming. But there are quite a few parameters on the Matriarch that we'd not be able to access without MIDI. This might be the longest video I've ever done. As always, I'll put an index in the description for those of you who wish to skip to the good parts. Here's a little demo of what we'll be working towards. In the intro, I was using Logic. I'm going to stick with it for this video, mainly because in version 10.5, they introduced a pretty happening little step sequencer. But if you want to stick with hardware, you can do the same thing with a sequencer like IntelliGel's Metropolix that has CV and MIDI functionality, or by using CV to MIDI or even MIDI to CV modules like Expert Sleeper's Disting. It's very easy to automate any parameter on any analog synth if you have a DC-coupled interface like Expert Sleeper's ES3 or ES8, or even ES9. I've recently been experimenting with my iPad and found a few fun ways of setting up hybrid systems that will accomplish the same thing and more. I'll probably make a video about that in the future. But, like I said, for today we're going to stick to something that I'm sure most of us own, a DAW. This will work in any modern DAW, but some of them it might work better than others. For those DAWs that don't have great MIDI functionality, a third-party sequencer like 512's Numerology is an excellent alternative. But today it's all about Logic Step Sequencer and the Matriarch. Okay, that was a long intro. Done. Let's get to it. So that we're all on the same page, let's start by putting together a stereo acid bass patch. Alright, let's just start with the saw wave oscillator. You get a stereo patch, we're just going to modulate the filter slightly. Same thing as just sort of turning the spacing or filter knob here. And let's add different amounts of resonance to each side of the filter. Cool, I like that. Okay, so I'm just going to patch the triangle LFO out into this attenuator here. And out of the attenuator, just going to go into cutoff VCF1. The attenuator obviously controls the amount of VCF modulation. In this case, we really don't need that much. All right, let's get a little bit more filter modulation from the envelope. That's good. Cool. And for now, I think we'll go with, full sustain from the amp EG. Okay, let's add in a second oscillator. Just turn up the mixer on oscillator 2 here. We can get the sound to sound fatter by making it slightly out of tune. All right, that's a good foreboding eerie bass sound. Something like Alessandro Cortini might use. I think we'll go with the more straight-ahead hard sync acid sound instead. Good. I think that sounds pretty good there. All right, and let's take the envelope out, patch it into an attenuator, and from the attenuator, we're going to go to linear FM in on oscillator 2. All right, that sounds good. We're getting a little gow or frequency modulation on our second oscillator, the synced one. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. I'm just going to grab a cable and sync the LFO to the arpeggiator. Might use it a bit later. All right, let's record a simple acid bass sequence. All right, we'll just stick with the little C minor thing. Actually, I think I want less sustain after all. It's more punchy. Yeah, I think sustain's gonna be something I play with later on. Let's add in a third oscillator, a square wave. Just make a few small adjustments. Speed up the LFO a bit. Yeah. I think that's pretty good. I think we'll stick with that for now. All right, that was a nice simple patch. I'll put up a patch diagram. You can get all these patches from our website, but let's get on to the main event. So I'm going to do a basic step-by-step walkthrough of the setup and logic. We'll just start by adding a software instrument. Just name it Matriarch for now, doesn't matter. Okay, that's good. Now over in the inspector on the instrument tab, we're going to select external instrument, picking stereo and selecting the Matriarch. You should have your Matriarch hooked up to the USB and selecting the audio inputs that I'm using. And there we go. Oh, we got to sync it up with the MIDI. So if you go to settings and click on the sync tab in the MIDI settings, then we'll find at the bottom MIDI sync project settings. We're going to find our synth. There it is, Moog Matriarch. Click the clock, done. Now the Matriarch will be sent a clock from Logic. Now if I hit play on the Matriarch, nothing will happen until I hit play in Logic. All right, now we're going to make a pattern. So command or right click, select create pattern. Still just a one bar pattern, but sometimes Matriarch acts funny on MIDI loops. Okay, now we're just going to delete all these rows here. All right, so if we click this little plus button, we can add lanes for MIDI control or MIDI CC parameters. It's going to add in channel 5 and 15. If you check the, you can rename them. If you check the manual, you'll find a list of all the CC parameters. There's a bunch of them. For now, we're just going to start with two of them, 5 and 15, which is glide time and sequencer gate length. I'll just rename them so there's no confusion. All right, let's start the sequence. And if you've used a step sequencer before, you're probably pretty much good to go by this point. If not, I'm going to walk you through it. First, I want to just add a bit of slapback delay. That's good. All right, we've got 16 steps to start. Let's activate them all. For now, it's a one bar pattern divided into 16th notes. If we click on the arrow, we get the lanes for the values. Let's put some in. All right, it's pretty obvious already what it's doing. Just gonna make an adjustment to the release on the amp EG here. Sequencer gate length is one of the parameters that you can only get to in real time, at least, with MIDI CC. And it's definitely a cool one to play with. So just make some adjustments. Sequencer gate length has been a common parameter to play with pretty much since the beginning of sequencing. It's a bit of a surprise that you can only get to it through MIDI on the Matriarch. But at least we can do it. All right, there's nothing to stop us from playing with the envelope values on the synth while the sequence is playing. Get a more dynamic patch that way, and of course it's more fun than just sitting and listening. This sounds good, but let's move on to the glide. All right, so same thing, we've got our drop down arrow, just add in our values here. Start with this step here. Oh, that sounds cool. More acid sound now, that's great. Cool, I like that, sounding good. All right, I think you get the idea. Let's play around a little bit with the filter and amp envelopes. Logic always has tons of little buttons everywhere that hide little secrets. This one here, it looks like a little page, kind of. I'll click it again. It's where we find templates and saved patterns. If you click this little circle thing, you can save your own templates and patterns. I've got a few saved here already. Matriarch CC All has all the assigned CC parameters named and assigned. I'll put a link on our website to these templates. You can download them and it will save you the 20 minutes or so that it would take to set this all up. If you download them, simply copy them to your settings folder. The default location is listed here. Okay, let's play around with a few more of these parameters. The noise filter cutoff parameter is another one that's, for practical purposes, at least only available through MIDI CC, but I'll come back to that one. Let's mess around first with oscillator 2's frequency. Oh, these little arrows here will quickly toggle on and off all your steps. This oscillator is still hard sync, so if we mess around with the frequency, we can probably get some pretty good squelches. Yep. Okay, when I switched templates, I deleted our glide and gate length that we had set up. I'm just gonna quickly get something good. All right, let's try messing around with oscillator 1's frequency. Aha, another secret, chance. Let's come back to that in a second. Let's just put in some values. That's cool. Okay, back to chance. So chance is simply the probability and percentage that a given step will be activated. And with this setup, using the drop-down menus, we have control over probability of every step in our sequence. Super cool. First, let's go back to values. We'll set this at 0 so you can see what I'm talking about. The values are unipolar, so it's not going to go any lower than any of the knob positions on the synth. Nice. Yeah, it'd be pretty much impossible to get this sequence on a Matriarch without using MIDI. You'd need a ton of different modules. Oh, I forgot to do the gate length. Hold on. Sequencer gate length and glide are really kind of codependent. Check it out. All right, let's try sequencer swing, another one that's kind of a pain in global settings. I like doing it this way because you can easily find a swing valve that you like. 64, by the way, is the value for no swing. And of course, we can try adding swing midway through our sequence. Yeah, a bit nutty, but might be worth exploring further in the future. Yeah, this is starting to sound pretty cool. So, what's next? As you see, we've got tons of different parameters we can play with. Let's try ARP rate. So, with a little bit of patience, we can probably set it up so it goes double time halfway through our sequence, or half time halfway through our sequence. Or it just sounds like crap. Oh, that was cool. I lost it. Put this back to 37, which is 16th notes. Starting to sound a little bit like Metropolix in skip mode. Okay, let's add in the DFAM and jam out a bit. Okay, still going, and I kind of lost focus there. The original question was, is it possible to automate the filter on the Matriarch? Well, let's find out. So just going to record a normal MIDI track and play with the cutoff knob and the mod wheel. That should do it. Okay, let's play it back and see if that was recorded. Nope, filter movement was not recorded, but yeah, you can hear the mod wheel was. Okay, let's double-click on our MIDI region and take a look. This little button here is our MIDI automation button. If this says track, you might want to click that until it says region. And down here is our MIDI automation lanes. So these are the ones that have been recorded. We've got modulation, note velocity, pitch bend, and aftertouch information. There's our mod wheel movements. So let's take a patch cable and go from our mod wheel out of the back of the Matriarch. And for now, I'm going to go into the molt it and go into the cutoff of both left and right channels. Mod wheel into the molt. Let's play the MIDI and we'll see if the filter is affected by the mod wheel. No, we're just hearing the actual mod wheel modulation, not the filter modulation. So this is what I was hoping to hear, lots of filter modulation. So that obviously didn't work, so we'll have to try something else. So double click again and let's open the aftertouch lane. So while I was playing, I was pushing hard with the keys. So let's take the aftertouch out, unplug our mod wheel from the molt, plug in our aftertouch from the back panel, and play our MIDI. Yep, that's working. Okay. Yep, good news. We now know how to automate our Matriarch filter. Yeah, although the mod wheel out of the back panel didn't behave the way I was hoping, the aftertouch does. So let's test it out. Okay, we'll just record some more MIDI here and see what happens. It might be a bit of a pain to automate in real time, but let's give it a go. I think we need pad more than keys. Let's crank up that release. Yeah, that's better. So I'm pushing pretty hard. Yeah, it's pretty straight ahead, not hard at all. The aftertouch is easy to control. But let's take a look anyway. Double click, check out. There's our aftertouch. Let's just loop this here for a second so we can hear it. Yeah, and just like any automation in Logic, well, first let's play it back. Yeah, it worked. Yeah, so like I was saying, just like any automation in Logic, we can just draw in lines if we want using the pencil tool or just edit the ones that we already recorded in. Let's give it a go. Let's go for sweeps. Yep. Works fine. Excellent. Okay, let's go back into our step sequencer, create a pattern, and try that out. Okay, I'm going to leave all these lanes in this time because we're going to try a paraphonic setup. We can quantize our sequencer here. This little drop-down menu, try minor pentatonic this time. drawing a bunch of notes. I'll just take some of them out, doubles for now. Kind of at random. Okay, that's fine. Loop it. Okay, make sure your matriarch is in paraphonic mode for voice. And if we click on the add row button over here. Okay, this time, instead of going to automation and choosing MIDI control values, we're going to use other MIDI. And we'll add channel pressure, which is just another word for aftertouch. And it works the same as the other lanes that we've already investigated. So make sure you've still got aftertouch from the back panel patched into the filter cutoff, and let's try it. Like I said before, these values are all unipolar, so it won't go lower than the knob position on your synth. So let's turn down the filter on the synth a bit and see what that sounds like. Yep, totally works. Cool. Sequencing the filter is, you know, a huge part of modular synthesis. Always sounds super cool. Okay, let's get some stereo filter modulation. So I'm going to patch into the attenuator here and invert the signal from our malt and send that into the inverted signal into our cutoff 2. Okay, let's go back into Logic. We've got a lot more parameters to mess around with here. We've got these little arrows here, which are play direction. Cool. And these ones are time divisions, obviously. Second notes and flip that to reverse. And let's try back and forth. Okay, you get the idea. I'm just gonna mess around with this until I come up with something I like. This is a pretty unique setup using the sequencer this way. It's a good way to brainstorm new ideas. As you're about to see, we'll get a paraphonic sequence. So I guess we can call this an 8-lane paraphonic sequencer. Let's add in the DFAM and have a listen. We can still add in any CC messages we want on top of this. Let's add in 74 oscillator 1 octave. We've got play direction here as well. Cool, let's just have a little listen. With all this modulation, it's going to be a fairly dynamic sequence. Cool. We're still going. Now what are we going to do? Let's make another pattern. Going to delete all the lanes but one this time, and we'll set up a single lane step sequencer. If we click on the drop-down menu here, you'll see we've got a bunch of parameters, and there's note. So we can use this single lane as a melodic sequencer as well. We can still add in MIDI CCs the way we did before, but I'm just going to bring in a template. This is my Matriarch single lane step sequencer template. And on the right over here, we've got our quantization settings. Let's go to the D, make that our home key. And instead of major, let's go for, let's try Dorian this time, nice minor. Now over here, we've got our notes. We've got octave, gate, tie, note repeat, and chance. We can add more if we want. Velocity is not going to do much. Let's add skip this time. Okay. And that's basically it. Oh, there's something I forgot to show you. If you command click or right click, whatever you want to call it, on one of these lanes, we have more options. We have randomized notes. It's another great brainstorming tool. So let's activate the steps and try it out. I actually really like that. We were lucky, lucked out the first time. We can do the same thing with octave. Yeah, and if you don't like it, right click, clear. It's that easy. Each one of these steps has random settings. That's cool. Okay, yeah, one thing. The Matriarch and MIDI don't always work so well together, especially in Logic. So usually I just extend my pattern for the entire length of the song. I can, of course, put in different patterns if I want, but we'll just stick with the one for now. Okay, just like before, let's experiment a little bit. If you keep the gates at really high values, it won't re-trigger the envelope, kind of acts like a tie, although we do have tie setting down below here. Let's experiment with note repeat. That's neat. Note repeat's just another word for ratchet. Skip is a parameter you'll find on pretty much every step sequencer ever made. It's self-explanatory. It simply tells the sequencer to skip that step. It's good for making odd time sequences, quickly shortening a sequence, or adding rhythmic variety. It's really best used as a real-time performance control, but it has its uses for composition for sure. I liked it the way it was though. Still got our chance or probability. Yeah, so I think I'll just mess around for a little bit. Okay, you get the idea. The only drawback that we have with this current setup is that we lose probability settings for individual parameters such as gate length, octave, or repeat. The chance setting now is a general probability for the entire step. But we do still have MIDI CC lanes with full control, and if we set things up this way, we have general settings that will apply to the entire sequence, like transpose and randomize. This is a really powerful sequencer. As you've seen, there's tons of options to mess around with. It's a great tool for performance and composition. But now that we're using Logic as our main sequencer in this patch, we've freed up the sequencer on the Matriarch to be used elsewhere. So let's keep patching. But we've got to do some global settings first. So first we have to detach the Matriarch from the sequencer. That's C-sharp 2, F-sharp 1, C0. Then we've got to go in and turn off sequence keyboard control, D-sharp 2, A-sharp 0, C0. And this one's very important. We have to turn off the, we have to filter the MIDI from the keyboard if we're using Logic as our sequencer. That took me a while to figure that one out. Okay. Now, all right, let's program in a sequence. Since it's going to be a CV sequence, let's just go with octaves so there's an audible change. Nice 8-step sequence. And I'm going to take the CV out of the arpeggiator, patch it into the mult. And I'm going to, let's start with the filter. So out of the filter into cutoff 1. And I'll go out of the other side, go again into the attenuator. Out of the attenuator into cutoff 2. And for now, we'll keep them both positive. And let's hear it. Cool. Let's turn down the filter a little bit. So now we have rate control, which are going to be time divisions. let's invert the sides. Play with the spacing. Cool. All right. Let's got another channel opener molt. So let's take a patch cable. And we're going to patch into the molt, into our attenuator, and into the linear FM of channel 2, oscillator 2. Nice. Okay, well, what the hell? Let's play around with some of the CC, MIDI CC values again. That's cool. Oh, I forgot about the noise filter. So this is a parameter that's only available through, in real time at least, through MIDI CC messages. Let's give it a go. So what it's doing is the noise filter cutoff. Let's just listen to the noise on its own. We need to add in the DFAM. Pretty cool. Okay, I think that pretty much covers pretty much everything I wanted to talk about, so I'm just going to experiment until the battery runs out on my camera. If you've stuck around this long, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.